Uncle's sons walk around without clothes in their house and it makes me uncomfortable. But my uncle doesn't care and told me to deal with it. I got removed from my parents' house by social services last week because my mom is going through some issues at the moment and is too depressed to leave her bed. I was first placed in a group home for foster children, though I don't think I'm a foster child because my mom is still caring for me. She is just going through something at the moment. I personally think I would have been fine staying at home because I'm very mature for my age, everyone tells me. But my grandpa reported my mom to social services, which is why I got removed. After being at the group home for a few days, my uncle finally got permission to take me in for a while until my mom is better. I don't know my uncle that well, he's my dad's brother, and since my dad died I haven't really had much contact with his side of the family. My uncle lives with his two sons who are 11, Oliver, and 9, Jamie. I've had to start sharing a room with Oliver, and Jamie shares with my uncle since there are only two bedrooms in the house. I hate this because at my proper house I have my own room and I just don't understand why I can't stay there. I've had to be removed from school because my uncle lives so far away and they're not able to get a place for me until September, which means I'm just sat at home doing nothing all the time. I just hate it here. When we're home, Oliver never wears clothes, sometimes Jamie too, but he usually wears underwear. But the second that Oliver gets home from school, he just strips completely. It makes me feel so uncomfortable and weird because why does he feel he can expose me to that? I don't like seeing it and it's just weird. I mentioned this to my uncle and he basically told me to deal with it, and that this was Oliver's house first. I told him that I think it's weird and it makes me feel uncomfortable. He doesn't understand how much of a change this has been for me. I don't even want to be here, and it's so weird that Oliver just won't wear underwear at least. It's not like it's a big deal. I don't want to see him undressed all the time. Especially when I invited my friend Max over, Max felt so uncomfortable that he left early when he was meant to stay for the entire day. I'm not allowed to go over to his house, which just makes it worse because now it's ruining my friendships. How old are you? Reach out to your social worker and explain that everyone in the new house walks around naked and you don't feel comfortable there. They will most likely try to find some other accommodation. It will not be a quick fix though. Oop, I'm almost 15, you will not be allowed to live alone. But they may be able to move you to another home. Keep pushing for it. If the social worker will not help, escalate it. State that you feel you are being sexually harassed by your cousins and uncle by being forced to see them naked. You can go so far as to say your uncle supports it. It may get messy and your family will blame you. Don't let them make you feel bad for this. You did nothing wrong and are having a bad situation forced on you because of mistakes others made. None of this is your fault. You will survive this, and you can potentially have a better life if you are able to separate yourself from them. I am so sorry you are going through this. It sounds really hard. Is there a social worker monitoring your foster placement? I'm wondering if there is any adult other than your uncle you could speak with about this. Oop, I don't really have anyone else, I have my grandpa, but he's not responding to me. Any way you can live with grandpa? Oop, no, I can't. I was told it wasn't a suitable placement for me. NTA, why can't you stay at your grandfather's house? Oop, I don't know, but for some reason they told me it wasn't a suitable placement, whatever that means. I can't even contact him, so I have no clue. Likely means they asked grandfather and he declined. Update 1. My uncle and I spoke about my cousins, and my uncle for once I think was really nice and reasonable. He apologized to me, said he was stressed with work and all the change and he shouldn't have taken it out on me. He said he shouldn't have said it was Oliver's house first because now it's all our house. He said he's going to speak to my cousins that they need to wear underwear around the house or a dressing gown. I told him I really was feeling lonely and depressed and that I wanted to get back into school. So we went back to my social worker and told them I really wanted to be put back in school and I'm feeling really depressed just sitting around the house. They managed to find me a place at a local school, which I started last Monday. Things have gotten better, but over the last few days I've been trying to organize a meetup with my mom, but she isn't answering my texts/calls and I'm getting a little worried about her. Last year I found her overdosed and had to call the ambulance, and I'm really worried she has done something to herself again. I've texted and called my grandpa also, but he's not responding. Does anyone know what I can do? Can I call the police to go and check on her? I'm glad to hear things are a little better. Are you from the UK? If so, call the police on 101 and ask for them to do a welfare check on your mother. Give the details that you are in foster care and that you have caught your mother attempting to commit suicide in the past. They should do a check and update you/your social worker, who will update you. Oop, thank you, I'll do that on the walk home from school today. My lessons start in 10 minutes, so I won't be online again until later today. Talk to your uncle about your worries about your mom. He is your guardian temporarily. You should also have a caseworker assigned to you. I suggest talking to both of them about your worries about your mom. Either one of them can call the police on your behalf regarding a welfare check. Unfortunately, the police don't always take minors seriously in these kinds of situations. Oop, I think someone told me on the last post that my social worker is my caseworker, because I think caseworker is just the American term for it, but I'm not sure. Okay, I will get back in contact with my social worker today if I can't get the police to do anything. Thank you. Okay, are you in the UK? In that case, I think your social worker should be the one to contact. They can contact the community mental health team if necessary. I wish you all the best, it must be awful being so worried about your mom. Oop, yeah, I am. It's all I can think about at the moment, so it's really worrying me. I just keep reliving the day I found her. I'm really mad at my grandpa because he's the reason I've already been forced to be removed from my mom, so I can't look after her, and now he's not even responding to me. Update 2. My uncle and I had a huge argument and he ended up throwing me out, which I don't know, maybe is a good thing. I didn't really like living with him. Currently I am with a very nice old lady and her other foster child. I finally managed to get in contact with my grandpa and I got an update about my mom. She's in hospital at the moment. She tried to end her own life again. I really feel awful, especially because I wasn't there to protect her. I know everyone here says it isn't my job to protect my mom, but if I were there she wouldn't have done this. I would have been there. I don't know how well she is and they aren't letting me visit. I asked my grandpa about why he took me away and then stopped responding to me and why he started to ignore me. He said he just didn't know what to say and that I was so angry at him. Which I am really angry. But I still wanted to talk to him. I don't really think Reddit is good for my mental health. People were sending me pretty horrible things to my DMs and telling me my mom had killed herself to get away from me. So I might not respond to any more messages and I'm not going to post any more updates. It sounds like the grandfather is trying but Oop is lashing out whenever they talk. I don't know what to say, you are just so angry from the grandpa. The Oop stating they know they are very angry but still want to talk is a tough one. I can see why the grandfather stopped answering calls if every exchange was Oop screaming at him about how he ruined Oop's life. Plus it sounds like the grandpa has his hands full with his mentally ill daughter. I don't see how everyone failed him. The mother was incapable and mentally ill, so Oop was removed. Placed in foster care but a family member took them in quickly. The underwear thing was nuts, but two similar aged boys sharing a room and a complaint about not wearing clothes, especially if it was very normalized before Oop lived there, may have not seemed significant to the uncle at the time. He rethought it, apologized, and tried to make changes. Oop never said what led to him leaving uncle's house, but he admits to being very angry. He talks a lot about why he just doesn't understand why he can't go home, and it is very possible he engaged in some sabotage of the situation thinking if he got kicked out they would let him go home. Social workers are checking in on him and got him enrolled in school. More than everyone failing him, I think he is a victim of very unfortunate circumstances. Dead dad and mentally / emotionally incompetent mother. Oop, you're just making up random shit about me. I haven't lashed out at anyone. My grandpa hadn't responded to me at all since I was removed and my messages to him consisted of hi hello how's mom? Could I get uncle to drop me off to visit mom? Hi, I didn't lash out at him. I never lash out at anyone. One thing I never do is lash out because that's what dad used to do and I know how it makes everyone else feel. My G, Grandpa didn't respond to me because he assumed I was upset at him, which I was. I never told him. I never lashed out at him or anyone else. Oop never said what led to him leaving uncle's house, but he admits to being very angry. Again, you're just making things up in your head to blame me, insinuating that it's my fault I was kicked out because I was angry. Saying I sabotaged it? I have never sabotaged anything. Nothing that has happened to me has been my fault, nothing. I do everything I can to make the people around me happy, everything. All the time. And I get nothing back. And yes, I asked my uncle's family to wear some underwear around the house. Jesus, is that so much to ask? No one puts me first, no one. The only person who even cares about me is my mom and she's going to fucking kill herself and I can't even fucking do anything to help her. Don't call her mentally incompetent. This is why I said I wouldn't look at the comments. People I don't even know are blaming me for things that didn't even happen. You're literally making things up in your mind to justify blaming me. I don't understand why people do this to me all the time. Good God, honey, even if you had lashes out, you have so much reason to not be okay right now, and the people sending you messages and being shitty to you are the ones who are mentally and morally incompetent. You are under too much stress for a person so young. I hope the people you are staying with now are nice and you can lean on them some. I'm on the wrong side of the ocean, but I'm still a mom and I would message with you if you need to talk. I hope the hospital helps your mom get better so you can be back with her at home soon. Take care and don't listen to the assholes. Oop, thank you. I knew I shouldn't have read the comments, yet I still did and it just made me more upset. I'm glad there are kind people out there like you and like my new foster carer. Who BTW is really kind and nice to me and is really trying to get me to see my mom. I've only been with her for a little while, but I feel like someone is finally taking my side and understanding how I feel. I'm embarrassed to say, but I cried so much yesterday and she was there just helping me, and that's something I've never had before. I've never had someone make me hot chocolate and let me pick a film and we just sat and watched it. I'm really hoping that this continues. Update 3. Some people were again mean and negative about me in the comments, like people just assuming I was violent and lashed out at my family. I don't do that, just setting the record straight. I never did that, not one. I think I was disrespectful to one commenter I replied to. They were assuming things about me and I was angry and disrespectful to them in my reply. I won't tag them in case they don't appreciate it. But I want to apologize to them, I'm sorry. I want to spread positivity and happiness, not negatively. I also took the advice of someone in the comments to turn off my DMs because that's where the really nasty or perverted people were messaging me. I am currently living with Jay, the old lady foster carer I told you all about. She is very nice. She's made me feel really welcome in her home and she's been fighting for me to be able to see my mom in person. I feel like I finally have someone fighting in my corner. For the first time in a long time, I feel really positive and happy. She even drove 30 minutes to pick up my friend from my old school so he could visit. I felt really guilty, but she acted like it was no big deal at all. I really, really hope things continue how they are and that my mom gets better soon and I can see her. Also, I feel guilty being a burden on Jay so much. I tried to clean the house for her when she was sleeping, but she came down and sent me to bed. She won't let me do chores for her, which is making me feel so guilty, and my grandpa would always say I would get lazy if I didn't do chores, but Jay isn't letting me. I feel so guilty because I feel really happy here. Like more happy than I've ever felt. But I don't understand why, and I feel guilty because I shouldn't be feeling happy while my mom is in hospital, but I do feel happy, and then I think of her and grandpa and just feel bad and guilty. I feel like I treat Reddit as my therapist, which probably isn't the best thing to do, but I usually feel better after I've written a post here. I'm going to go to bed because it's 11 p.m. here.